accepted.
The scene opens to a jail cell where Summer is chained up with blue glowing handcuffs.
Why is her power so overwhelming? There has to be a way around it. It's just like the last time.
The scene slowly fades into a flashback where Chio is on the screen wearing the mask across her face this time.
That color scheme, that outfit, is she the new Joker? Careful, I sense a very powerful presence coming from that young lady. I think we should retreat for now.
What? That's nonsense. You're afraid of her? I'm not afraid of her. I can fight her right now by myself. I don't even need your help.
Pace yourself, Autumn. That dial is Joker, which means Heaven must still be alive somehow.
Oh, you're familiar with Heaven. Hey, guess that makes everything easy. You're the Four Seasons, right? I'm here to make sure you don't enter the Earth's realm.
A huge swarm of golden butterflies start to circle Chio's body.
Yeah, we should definitely get out of here.
The butterflies quickly combined and made one giant golden beam that smacked Springer before he could finish his sentence. Autumn attempted to dash towards her, but as if she vanished. And before she knew it, Joker was in front of her, and she was encased in the same golden barrier that she put Saki in.
I'll make a deal with you. You promise to stay right here, and I won't lay another finger on you. Just don't come anywhere near Earth, or you will regret it.
Summer, realizing she was outmatched, agreed to her terms. All right. Fine, we won't go anywhere near it. Just release Autumn, and we'll get out of here.
Smart choice.
Chio snapped her fingers and the prison broke that was around Autumn. Without hesitation, they teleported back to their base. The flashback ends and it goes back to Summer in a prison cell. She could hear a familiar voice talking just outside the room.
I'll get her to talk, trust me.
The door opened and in walked a familiar face. Summer's eyes were widened when she saw who it was.
Magyaku? You?
It's actually Sergeant Magyaku now.
What is the meaning of this? Were all of you hypnotized by those Phantomi or something?
Hypnosis? Is that what you think this is? Nah, we were in the wrong, and you know we were in the wrong. They just opened our eyes, that's all.
But I'm not here to chit-chat with old friends. So tell me, what are you here for? I know it's not just mana. You've clearly found other places, even when I was still part of the team. So why Earth? Why did you decide to come back?
The screen zooms in on Summer as she says just one word. Kumachi.
Ew, here we go, episode 14, which is partially spoiled by Yuri. And you know the drill. If you haven't seen the most recent episode, the ticker is right there. Let's hop into it.
The scene opens to a hospital, and Tiffany is laid out unconscious in the bed as a doctor walks into the room. So what are we looking at here? How bad is it?
4 broken ribs, severe lumbar spinal cord fractures, and the other doctor paused for a moment. Severe damage to the hypothalamus.
So then possible amnesia as well.
To be honest, it's a miracle she survived at all, actually.
The screen zooms in on the electrocardiogram as the heart rate gets slower and slower until... Without hesitation, the two doctors ran towards Tiffany, doing all they could within their power to save her, grabbing defibrillators and everything. The scene changed to something considerably more lighthearted, as it's now focused on Yotsuba and Fuka grocery shopping.
Yosuba was pushing a tiny little shopping cart around that was filled to the brim with chicken nuggets and absolutely nothing else. I'm pretty sure you're missing a few things from your cart there. Oh, you're right. I need ketchup. And honey mustard. Gotta have the honey mustard. What kind of weird diet? Put some of those back. In fact, put all of that back. That's more than enough. No, it's okay. I can afford it. Don't you like chicken nuggets? I mean, yeah, I like them, but we need more than that. Just because we're not with our parents watching us like a hawk with our diet doesn't mean we have to eat junk food all the time. I never said we had to. I just prefer to. Two bags. Two bags only. Take it or leave it. Deal. I'll keep two big bags, Yosuba said while checking her phone. She dropped a bag of nuggets on the floor and just stood there, still as a statue. What? What is it? What's wrong? Being in the same group chat, Fuka's phone eventually went off, so she stopped and read the same message that Yotsuba just did. This is... it's horrible. Tiffany. The scene changes back to the jail cell that was holding Summer, and Lieutenant Baruti walks into the room. Leave us. I want to talk to her one-on-one. With that, the two SPAT members that were with him just looked at each other and nodded their head and turned around and walked out the door. I've already told you everything that you want. What more do you want with me? Lieutenant Baruti walked up to her and grabbed the glowing handcuffs. I want you to get out of here. He suddenly transformed into Autumn and snatched the handcuffs off of Summer, shattering them. Sorry it took so long. Did you miss us? Just outside the door, they could hear Commander Baruti talking to the other SPAD members. I didn't ask to talk to Summer. You idiots! One of them is a shapeshifter. I'm guessing you're too weak to teleport, but we got this under control. Evan has a teleporter right outside. Just follow me. Autumn fired a tornado from her hands, bursting the door off the hinges and pulling in two SPAT members as they twirled around in front of Baruti as he rolled out of the way at the last minute. He balled up his fists and both of his gloves started to glow with a blue energy. He ran up and grabbed the tornado, absorbing it into his gloves, dropping the two SPAT members that were twirling around. You're not getting out of here that easy. A giant spear of ice erupted from the floor, just barely missing Baruti. With that brief distraction, Autumn tossed Summer onto her back and ran straight past Baruti and the other two SPAT members. A red bolt of lightning flew past Autumn and struck the ceiling in front of Baruti, causing it to fall down in front of him and the SPAT members, trapping them where they couldn't get to Autumn. Heh, they're not in the clear yet. They picked the wrong day to try to do a prison break. Autumn and Summer made it outside, expecting to get to their teleporter and get out of there, but they were stopped in their tracks by an unlikely hero. Standing before them was a guy in a silver outfit wearing a phantom mask. He had a gold cape on his back, white gloves, black boots, and a silver belt around his waist. His hair was also a shining silver color, and in his hand was a whip-like weapon. Autumn, that's the king model. You can't take him alone. You always doubt me. I probably could take him alone, but luckily we're outside and we have a signal. So, Autumn pressed a button on her wrist. Contingency plan. And her and Summer both teleported away. Huh. Of course, they take the coward's way out. Pretty sure they won't stay gone for long. Check on Baruti and the others. The scene changes back to the hospital. And Tiffany is sitting up in the bed, awake, just staring blankly at the wall. She feels the bandages wrapped around her forehead and then looks down at the bandages wrapped around her hands and notices the amount of cuts and scratches on her. It's right at that moment that the doctor from earlier comes walking into the room. Oh, good. You're awake. Do you remember your name? Tiffany just looked blankly at her. Okay, let's try a different approach. She repeated the question in Japanese this time. And Tiffany responded in Japanese, saying, I don't know. I don't remember. How did I get here? You were in a pretty bad car accident 2 days ago. Can you remember anything at all from before that? I can't remember anything. All I can remember is... face of some girl, and I'm not even sure who it is.
A girl?
Yes, we were arguing about something, and I don't remember what, but she was really upset with me. She was hurt. She was bleeding.
An injured girl?
The driver of the armored truck that hit you was a male. Was this before the accident?
I believe so. I was standing on a rooftop.
Do you remember anything else? Anything at all could help.
No, I can't remember what we were fussing about. In fact, the only thing I remember is maybe one sentence.
And what is that?
At that moment, Aisha came walking into the room.
Tiffany, you're awake.
She just looked blankly at Aisha as she didn't really remember how to speak English.
I'm sorry, but your friend has a severe case of amnesia and she doesn't really remember the English language.
This is all my fault. If I could have stopped her before she stormed off, I could have prevented this whole thing.
Strive to make your dreams a reality against all odds.
I don't understand. What did she just say?
The girl. Her name was Mariko, and she didn't want me to give up on my dreams. But I don't even remember what those dreams are anymore. I guess I let her down.
You just take your time and rest as much as you need. I'm going to have a talk with your friend. I'll be back.
The doctor took Aisha and stepped outside of the room. We talked to her parents while she was out, and they're on the way here. They're going to be taking your friend back to Japan with them, they decided.
I can understand that. It's for the best. At least until she gets her memory back and can speak the language again.
She will get her memory back eventually, right?
In most cases like this, yes. After the brain has a little bit more time to heal, something can jog those memories and she'll get them back. Though the issue we have is, I'm not sure if she'll ever walk again. The scene changes, and for the first time since they all entered college, all four of the Phantomi are together again.
So they managed to let Summer escape somehow. I guess that means we can expect more trouble from them.
That's been bothering me for a while now. They're not stealing reverse energy, so what is their purpose of attacking us this time?
Saki crushed the cake that she was eating into a little paper cup and started pouring soda on top of it.
Are you seriously still eating that? What's wrong with you?
Saki didn't want to talk with her mouth full, so she just nodded her head and held her thumbs up.
Maybe we can try asking Yuri. You think maybe she knows what they're up to? She's always sneaking around and gathering intel. That's her thing.
I haven't seen her in a while. Where is she anyway?
Standing right behind you.
Don't do that. How are you so good at sneaking up on people?
You guys just aren't aware of your surroundings. I wasn't even trying to sneak that time.
So have you figured out anything? Do you know what they're after?
Oh, I know exactly what they're after. I've known for a while. I'm just not allowed to tell you.
What's that supposed to mean?
It means it's bedtime. Mukinisuru.
With that, Kumachi fell asleep once again. Akia quickly stood from the table and grabbed her Phantomi Dao.
What kind of trick is this? Are you one of them in disguise? Is this Autumn?
Calm down. The only rule that Mom gave me is that I can't tell Kumachi. But what I'm about to tell you, you must make sure he does not find out. Not until it's time.
He's an important member of the team. Why do we have to keep a secret from him?
Because you run the risk of putting the whole world in danger. You love Earth, don't you? You do like this place, right?
You're not making any sense. What's going on here?
Okay. Kumachi's not a fairy. In fact, there's no fairy that looks anything like him because Fandy did not open a realm to the fairy world. He opened a realm to the world of the gods.
The girls all gasped in shock. Wait. Are you saying what I think you're saying?
There's two gods governing this world. And Kumachi happens to be the god of order,
his counterpart being Chaos.
I spoke with Fandy and got the details. Apparently, they used his energy when creating the Phantomirage and Dao. Well, four of them anyway. You see, there's four other ridiculously powerful, unstable ones. The ones that the other Phantomy team is using. Those are powered by his counterpart, the God of Chaos. And if we let the four seasons of darkness get a hold of both order and chaos, we'll have no way to stop them whatsoever. There we have it. The cat is out of the bag. We now know what it is the four seasons of darkness are after. They're after a power that lies deep within Kumichi. What does this mean for the Phantomy? What does this mean for Earth itself? If this power were to fall into the wrong hands, nothing could stand in their way.